will never know what that means to me. That is everything. Everything. We love you, boys. We love you.
Pickford, you beauty! You beauty! Yes! Now we hold. We do not give in. We do not allow them to score.
We do not argue, quite frankly. Ross Kemp is here alongside former England player Ray Parlour. Good to see you. You're still a bit hoarse from all
I
that,
am a bit.
You?
Can you hear that?
Yeah.
I have to watch it on my own. There is now a routine.
Why?
Ray and I having a conversation. I'm not going to jinx anything. I'm never going to play for England. Ray has, obviously.
He's got into a routine.
There's a routine there, and I'm not breaking it.
So what, for the first match, you watched on your own? And
yeah.
OK, and then that's it now?
I generally have to watch it on my own, because I'm a danger to myself and others if
right.
I don't.
Because your twins are still quite little, aren't they?
They are. I am banished to the other end of the house.
Right. A hot room.
A hot room, clearly.
Is that a routine for everyone as well?
Well, you know, I'm not going to change anything. I mean, Ray, when you were playing, you...
Oh, yeah, routine's your routine, so you can't change it now, and it's winning at the moment, so it's working, Ross, so
Ross,
keep it going.
It's all down to you.
No, I don't think so.
And you're topless. We did get you a shirt.
Oh, thank you. What are you trying to say?
You're not going to wear it now, are you?
You're trying to say it.
You're breaking the routine.
No, but I'll have it sitting next to me.
Yeah, there you go. Just pop on.
Ray, Gareth Southgate was your manager at Middlesbrough.
He was indeed.
You had a bit of a run-in with him, of your sense of humour.
Yes, it wasn't ideal, really. I called him Big Nose one day, and I never played again. So I was quickly going back down to London after that. But he was a great guy. He really was. He dressed him. He was just being a fan, and I said it at the wrong time in a meeting one day. Because it was really difficult, because when you're a player and then suddenly you're a manager, you have to be a little bit different because you're one of the lads, now you're not. You're the boss.
Yeah.
But he was more or less trying to explain that, you know, I'm now the boss, the gaffer, and I just was mucking about as I usually do. And I said, Big Nose. I went, oh, no. It went quiet. It wasn't a good reaction after that. Well, Croatia, a good side. There's no doubt. There's a lot of people's dark horses before the tournament started. You know, got good midfield, very experienced, Modric and Rakitic and people like that. So that's where the game will be won.
I feel really nervous while you're talking.
I'm very nervous because, you know, I really want Gareth to get them players. We're one step away from the World Cup final, which is an amazing situation.
Two wins away from being the best team in the world.
He will be Sir Gareth then. He'll be Sir
Gareth. We need the trophy. We've got the cup. Let's get the trophy. We're doing everything. This is now going to have to be my routine, isn't it?
Absolutely.
All the way. When you're watching as a former England player, do you think, oh, my God, I wish I could get out there. Do you think, thank God I'm not there because the pressure's
Well, I'm an England fan now, obviously. Yeah. So I want the best for England. But you do miss it.
You'd
love to be involved in the dressing room area and how they're playing.
What's the buzz like before?
Oh, you won't get a bigger buzz than walking out of the stadium in front of fans. You know, you can train hard all week, but the game on a weekend is always the most important time. And then players will be nervous because you're into a semi-final, but it's a good... It's a good experience to have, and I'm sure they'll take this in and do well.
Ross, what we need is a motivational speech by someone with enormous amount of passion.
You'll be number two, sir.
Look, I think we were talking about this earlier. I think we've played them six times, we've won four times. Mm. Let's make it five.
Oh, come on. We need more than that.
All right, okay.
Can't be that easy.
Are you going to keep your shirt on?
For
the time being. But look, I am Jekyll and Hyde. Once they walk out onto that pitch...
Yeah.
Then come on, England!
Wow. Motivates me.
Oh, it's fantastic to see. Are either of you going to do anything special for Wednesday if we get through to the final on Sunday? I mean, do you have... I know you've got a routine.
They can offer me a Learjet all the way to Moscow with caviar and whatever you want. Fine wines. I'm staying in my little hot room with my two beers because it's working.
We might
stretch it to four.
I'm gonna probably watch it down the pub probably with all the supporters, and it's always a great atmosphere. And you know, I've seen the pictures of around the country how people are celebrating, and it's wonderful
to
see.
We had Danny Dyer's view on Brexit, so we want the Ross Kemp view on Brexit.
Well. It'll either be Brussels or Paris in the final, won't it, if we win on Wednesday? So they're all good omens as far as I'm concerned.
And then we have to beat them, don't we?
We have to beat them.
Yeah.
Come on, England.